Hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. In the last episode, we took out actually two Arzuros. We hunted one, killed one, and then we captured one, so I could demonstrate what capturing actually meant. This episode, we're going to take on ourselves a Royal Ludroth. So all you really need to know about the Royal Ludroth is that he's big. He's actually the first monster we're going to encounter that you can actually cut off his tail if you have a cutting weapon, so like a long sword or like I think lances, maybe, I don't know, great swords, that sort of stuff. I'm gonna be using my Kuropeko trumpet, so there'll be no cutting of the tail for me. But to be honest, I'm really bad at trying to cut off tails of monsters, so that's not really something that I try to aim for. What you do want to bring on the hunt, though, is you want to bring a fire elemental weapon. Works really well on these guys, oddly enough. I know it's a water species, yet you can use fire against it. That kind of seems a little bit backwards. You may also want to bring, if you want to capture it, Royal Ludroth does spend a lot of time in the water, so you may want to bring a shock trap, which works underwater and on land, whereas pitfall traps only work on land. And you may also want to bring a... where is he? That one. You may also want to bring any sort of like oxygen recoveries, because if you're going to be a lot of swimming, you're going to be underwater. Obviously, we have an air supply limit, so you might want to, you know, it's not necessary, but you may want to bring stuff that, ooh, we're in the flooded forest. You may want to bring items that replenish your oxygen, that's the word. So we already got mini oxygen supplies. We got null berries because his water attacks can cause water blight, which usually I ignore the blights, I'll be honest. I'm not big on healing myself about that. I probably should be though. Anyways, let's run out, find ourselves a Royal Ludroth. Hello ladies, you're not royal enough for me, unfortunately. You're itty bitty. I'm looking for big Ludroth. So he might be hanging out probably somewhere in 3, 4, or 5, I'm guessing. It's kind of pain in the butt, the water hunts. I'm not a big fan of water hunts because I'm not really good at swimming. But thankfully, Royal Ludroth does spend enough time on land. It's not a big deal. Actually, he's probably in Area 4 is my guess. We don't want to deal with these little guys. I don't even know what they're called. They're called, like, Epioth or something like that? Yeah, something like that. They're pretty much harmless. There's only once they've ever attacked me. It wasn't that big of a deal. Alright, is your alpha male kicking around somewhere? Where could he be? We'll find him. Oh, there's just a little bubbles coming off from the bottom of the floor of the lakes and the ponds and the oceans that you swim in, so you have more opportunity to get air there as well. Where is he? Ah! Found him! There you go! Finally! Found him! Shut up! Area 4. Because he's a pain in the butt, let's paint him pretty pink. And there's our Royal Ludroth. Okay, so Royal Ludroth, his weak point is his mane. So we're gonna hit that. Oh, that's bad. He does this side roll, which, in my opinion, does crazy amounts of damage, and it always puts me in a bad mood. But, and all of his little females can be kind of a pain in the butt, too. Anything spectacular about him? He does these water attacks, and actually, they're kind of dictated by how full his mane is. So, eventually you can keep beating on him, and his mane will go down in size. His mane's also breakable, so you might want to pay attention to that, too. Oh my gosh! His tail is huge too, and I feel like his tail always catches me in his spins like that. Alright, but you can tell when he's gonna go, because he'll shake his head. Ladies, get away from me! Don't want a part of you, be a part of you. Oh, and run out of the way! Uh-oh. Yeah, his tail always gets me. I feel like it shouldn't, but it does. So, whatever. However, okay, yeah, so his mane will go down, which... It's nice if you're in dry areas, but we're not really in a dry area. We're in a wet area because he can replenish his mane. It's like a sponge. And so he'll replenish it by touching water, like rolling in water and whatnot. Oh, get out of the way. He's going to lunge. Yeah, most of the fighting in this game is basically figuring out the tells of all the monsters and, like, how you know when they're gonna do stuff. So, like, when he lurches backwards, he's gonna lurch forward. He'll kind of shake his mane when he's gonna do a roll. That sort of stuff. He'll kind of shake his head that way, and he'll start doing this water gun thing. Alright. Get him a few times. Uh-oh. That was kind of a side roll charge. I think it's called a Leviathan monster? Or a Leviathan something? Just a Leviathan, actually, I think. Looks like he's puffing already, so that's good. I'd be going to the water then soon, and I'd rather him stay on land. Alright. Come on, buddy. Keeps jumping about. Apparently, they're rather agile. Rather quick. Oh, gosh. Yeah, I feel like his lunges and his lurches are far too... Oh, his tail's gonna get me. It's far too long. Oh, and I'm stunned. Uh-oh, guys, help me. Somebody help me. Or you can just smash X and become unstunned. Basically, if something hits you, or you become unstunned, or if you keep mashing X, you can become unstunned. Stop hitting me, Ludroth. Please, where are my little buddies? Oop, out of the way. Alright, you can also break his crest on his face. Sometimes too, it'd be nice because they will attack themselves. Like he'll attack his lovely ladies. Oh, there goes the tail again. Ooh, sometimes they get caught up in a combo attack of some sort that I don't get out of the way. Alright. Oh, he keeps calling his lady Ludroth over, they're pain in the butt. Alright, he's going off to the next area though. So let's follow him in hot pursuit. Sometimes what you want to do is, because especially these water ones, I think I mentioned last episode, make sure that they're in the next area before you go in there, because sometimes you can like surpass them and pop up in front of them. But I think we're fine for now. We got tons of stamina, we can do lots of swimming. Alright, actually I feel like Royal Ludroth, what is he doing? Just chilling there? Is he eating something? It's actually mildly easier to fight underwater. That might just be a weird opinion of mine. Actually, I'm not proving it that my opinion is correct. Because he kind of waits and stuff like that, but still, the underwater fighting can be kind of a pain in the butt. Hello, Ludroth. Have some smack in the face. I don't know. Just have to kind of hope you hit him. Sometimes it can be tough. He looks so cool though. I love his look. He's maybe one of like my favorite looking monsters, even though I don't fight him very often. I'd say probably one of my you know, earliest monsters favorite to fight are actually Kuropeko. I really like fighting him for some reason. Maybe because he can do such a wide variety of things. Alright, oh, he broke his mane! That's awesome. Our weapon's power is decreased, but whatever. He's okay. He doesn't have any, like, ricochets or anything like that. Or bounces, I guess is what they're technically called. Ooh, he's all skinny now. Oh, and he doesn't have the power to spit water balls anymore. But I'll just keep attacking with my yellow sharpened weapon. Come on, you. Destroy. Thank you, somebody, for giving me a slight health boost. That's lovely. Always appreciate it. Oh, we're starting to bounce off stuff, so we might have to apply... Yeah, we're gonna have to sharpen our weapon. Maybe, if I can get out of the way. So let's grab our mini whetstone. Sometimes it can be a little bit dangerous doing this, because you don't want... Oh, somebody... They broke something else off of him. Oh, I think they broke his crest or something like that. He dropped a shiny, too, so we'll have to grab that. Oh. Let's sharpen our weapon. Hopefully he won't hit us. Sometimes you have to be really careful. Oh, I thought he was going to miss us. I was gonna be like, oh, I missed him. But yeah, sometimes monsters will get you when you're in the middle of doing something else. Let's grab that tier or whatever it is. A wyvern tier. We did. It's usually tiers. So that's why I guess it's tiers. Alright. Come on, buddy boy. Oh. He's kind of in, I think he's in rage mode right now. You can kind of tell for some of them, they have glowing eyes. Yeah, his eyes definitely look glowy. He looks mad. Oh, that would hurt. Just die, Ludroth. Yeah, I don't have any traps with me, so I'm gonna have to kill him. Not that it's a big deal. I think, where's he going? I'm not showing any signs of limping yet. Alright, get your bearings. I've definitely gotten better, thankfully, at the whole underwater fight. But, oh, now he's limping. There he goes. Sometimes it's hard to see at first with this guy, because he swims like in this circular like pattern, but you can tell he's limping because it goes smoothly and then goes ka-thunk. And it goes smoothly and ka-thunk. And he'll probably actually, if you can't get him enough, when he starts limping, he starts heading to Area 8. That's where, in this area, where the monsters will go if they are sore, and they'll go and they'll sleep there, too. So, he has a resting place up there, where he'll go, and some of the other monsters will just chill out in the bottom of the water there in Area 8, the blue part. Don't hurt me. Oh, I got it. You hope to fight that. I hope you're good enough. Cha-cha, when have I ever doubted you? Alright, where is he? Where'd he go? Why did he go so quickly? Alright, he's doing that. Let's give him a big swat on the main. I'm not sure if he takes more damage if you hit an already damaged main. There are some monsters that when you break something on them... Oh, I went right into his jaws. When you break apart on them, that becomes like an even weaker spot. I'm not entirely sure if that's true for Ludroth. Alright, oh yeah, I'm not even paying attention to my oxygen gauge. And there's usually so many bubbles around that you don't have to worry about it. Alright, he's gonna be heading to Area 8 then. Oh, see, we're in my face, can't see. You can try keeping up to them swimming wise, but I usually have a problem trying to like swim up really fast and then hit them. Did that time, but usually I can only get like one hit off of them. Sometimes you can bother them enough that they'll actually stop going to that area. Oh no, he's still going. Maybe if he... Okay, I'll let him go in there so you can see what they do and how this can be of advantage to you. So we'll let him go in Area 8, and you can see he's this little pink dot where he's slowly limping himself away. And we'll wait for him to go on land, and he'll kind of like settle in the top corner there, and hopefully he'll fall asleep. And then we can like sneak up on him and smash him right in the head or something like that. I think you get like extra damage when they're actually sleeping, too, when you hit them. So that's good. And by the time you actually get them, sleeping doesn't really do a whole bunch of recovery for their health. I don't even know if it does, actually. I usually just end up killing them not too long after. Alright, I think we waited long enough. He should be up there sleeping like a little baby. So yeah, we'll hopefully get a good hit on his head and we'll be good to go. And I don't think the little Ludroth will wake him up. No, there he is, all curled up. They're so ungraceful when they jump onto land. Anyways, good morning, sir! It is a fine day in the neighborhood, is it not? Alright. There we go. Just a few more whacks on you and you should be done. Hopefully, oh, okay, and some more wax on me. That's fair enough. You're allowed to. Alright, so let's just put that away. You can run faster, too, without the weapon, so that's why I put my weapon away. Plus, I think you're hit when you run up to him and unsheath your weapon. You do extra damage, I think. I read that somewhere. Alright, you snap at me. And a few more hits to you. You should be gone soon. Oh, my weapon power decreased again. Oh, there we go. Objective complete before you could spit a water ball at me. Oh, although he was sitting on the nest. Maybe Ludroth, maybe the males help look after little eggies the females lay. Who knows? Anyways, let's carve ourselves up some Ludroth. We get some pretty nice stuff here. Lots of stuff for weapons and Ludroth armor. I've never actually gotten Ludroth armor, but it's probably okay. I don't know. You get some spongy or like spongy hides. I think if you break his mane, which we did. Ooh, dash extract. I think you need that for like a kind of a request, a villager request later on. Aw, look at him. Well, I mean, he's not sleeping. He's dead. He's not gonna wake up from that slumber. But yeah, Ludroth are one of my favorite ones, not to fight, but like aesthetic wise. I think they look super cool. I get how they got their fierce front feet, and then their little sleek paddle back feet. Just for little brothers. Yes, Kayamba! Super excited! Oh my god, let's dance! Quest complete! I don't know what that was. Anyways, let's take our rewards. Or send them to the item box. Rather, we got a Ludroth scale, Ludroth crest. You get that for breaking his face. Some dash extract, spongy hide. We'll take an adamant seed, more spongy hides, and another crest. Perfect. And we'll sell the Nullberry because nobody needs it. Alright, no new records, but that's okay. This isn't about new records, and if we do happen to get one, that's wonderful too. Alright, so I think that's it for this episode. We did a pretty okay job taking down the Royal Ludroth. In the next episode, I believe we'll be tackling the Barath, a brute wyvern. I'll see you guys in the next episode.